So let's wag the rudder. Enjoying your glider lessons so far?
Oh, I'm having a great time.
Awesome. You're what, in seventh grade?
Eighth.
Eighth grade?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. I just got all my lessons, and I think today was my last lesson.
Yeah.
Because Bruce says I'm ready to solo and stuff, but I'm just not 14 yet, so.
Yep. Well, at least you're ahead of the game. After my 14th birthday, October 25th. I guess that's about 3 weeks after my birthday. The air is nice and smooth up here.
Oh, yeah.
On the last flight, I did encounter one thermal, though. So there are some out here today, just not too many. When you get older, or are you going to do something totally different?
I want to get into family business. I want to kind of take over from my dad.
Yeah, that's pretty much what I did.
Yeah.
It's a lot easier to take over something that's already up and running than it is to start something from scratch.
Yeah.
tired on tow? It's not so hard. It's just right. Like the Tinker Tinker. If you don't want to, that's okay. Just flying with one finger and my thumb. But the same basic rules apply. We're just holding the pitch attitude that we want, matching our bank angle to his, and keeping it coordinated. That's it. So if that remains your focus, then it's relatively easy. Towed up this high yet before?
We're
at 5,200 or so.
I'm not sure. I think so, yes.
Yeah, you might have had a few lessons where we towed up extra high. So what other things do you like to do for fun? Some physical activities,
yeah.
Some sports. And it's good to play sports that are individual sports and also team sports.
Yeah. I'm going to start wrestling for the wrestling season starts.
Nice.
Soon as we get back.
My cousin's kids are really into wrestling. They really like it.
Yeah, my cousin, Mary, the wrestling coach at Rocket.
Yeah.
His dad is the wrestling coach at Everly, and that's, you probably don't know where those are.
No, that's okay.
But.
Well, let's see. It's good to get into diverse sports, too, because physically they use a lot of different muscles and different types of coordination. I think it's not so good when kids only play one particular sport. A little bit first, and then I'll hand it over to you.
The airspace and all that?
Yeah. All right. Seems pretty good. And I've got the trim set. Okay. You have control. So a good speed to cruise around is around 50. You'll notice a little yellow triangle on the airspeed indicator.
Yes.
So maybe lower our pitch just a little bit. We'll fly a little faster.
This is a lot more sensitive.
It is. So, you just use your fingertip and the tip of your thumb and kind of rest your arm down on your leg so it's supported. And that way you can just apply pressures with your fingers or your wrist. And I think I forgot to adjust the rudder. Did they adjust those for you? Can you reach it?
Yeah, I can reach it.
Okay. Well, try some turns. Just like in the other aircraft, you just slowly roll in, slowly roll out, hold the pitch attitude steady. And it probably takes a little more rudder than the 233 does.
Yeah.
But if you're applying the aileron pressure slowly, it's easier to keep up with the rudder pressure. Fly a little faster, that reduces how much rudder input you need as well. So you can tweak the speed a little and make it a little easier. Excuse me. Great view today, huh?
Oh, yeah. Clear skies.
Yeah, mostly. Let's try a turn back to the right. So more rudder. There you go. That's it. So that's downtown Phoenix straight ahead. That's Four Peaks Mountain in the distance straight ahead. Having a good time?
Oh, yeah.
Good. There you go. That was pretty good. You know, it's not super critical that the Austrian stays exactly straight the whole time.
Yeah.
But that's kind of the goal. And up here, if we're a little uncoordinated, it's not the end of the world. At lower altitudes, you want to be more precise with it. Yeah, you're doing super. Makes my job easy.
Yeah.
You want to try some speed changes?
Sure.
Yeah. Lower the nose and see what happens. Do anything wrong. Not with me here with you, not at this altitude. So the sound does change as you accelerate, but it still stays pretty darn quiet.
Oh yeah, for sure. This is fun to fly.
Yeah, isn't it? Yeah, these fiberglass ships are really awesome. But you can see why they're not so great for training compared to the 233, because they're so much more sensitive. Certainly you can train in them, and we do train in them sometimes, but it takes longer to reach proficiency. This general area, you can play around with it, do some different turns and things. You can try steeper turns or shallow turns, whatever. The key is to have consistent pitch attitude and to keep looking around outside so you can see the orientation of the glider and to look for traffic and birds and all that good stuff.
Yeah.
And like any other type of aircraft, when it's new to you, it is a little difficult. It takes some time to get acquainted with an aircraft type, or even an individual aircraft. And after a while, it becomes second nature. But it's really good to fly lots of different types of aircraft, so you can become more adaptable and flexible. And that way, when you have things like an engine quit on you, or you know, the CG is different from what you're used to flying at, it's not as big a deal. Just continue this turn around to the left until we're pointed back at the sailport again. And then we'll get ready for some aerobatics. Yeah, that's a nice clean turn. There you go, you're getting the hang of it. Remembering to breathe is really important.
Right.
And when you're holding your breath, your body tenses up, and the muscles get tense, and then you can't be as smooth. But that's kind of the natural instinct, when under stress, is to kind of hold your breath a little.
Yeah.
So if you remind yourself to breathe periodically and to have a light grip on the stick, then it helps a lot. Yeah. All right. I guess I have control.
Okay.
All right. I'm just going to stash my hat in the back here.
Should I do something with my hat?
No, your hat's fine. I've just taken mine off so I can see a little bit better, which is more important for me since I'm piloting.
Yes.
And when we're doing the aerobatics, just hold on to your black shoulder harness. Yep, just right up there like that. And feel free to laugh or scream or giggle or whatever.
Oh,
or just sit there and smile, that's fine too. And it's like I said before, this flight's for you, so while it's enjoyable, we'll keep going.
Okay.
If it stops being enjoyable, you just tell me.
Can do.
All right, so I've cleared the area, it looks all good. We'll start with the loop. Okay. Here we go. There's a tow plane. You're fine. Here we go.
That's amazing. That was the greatest thing.
Is that great?
Yeah, that's amazing.
Get down to pattern altitude. So we always stop the aerobatics up high, so we have plenty of time to check the windsock and get ready for the landing and synchronize with the other traffic. Attitude in this is normally lower than what it would be in the 233. So it takes a while to adjust where you want to put the pitch. It takes a little getting used to. Yeah, let's go straight ahead. Why don't you push the nose down lower and we'll zoom up to about, 75 knots or so. I'll be right behind you, right with you. So push the nose a little lower. She's picking up some speed. Now let's roll into a turn to the right and bring the nose up above the horizon. There you go. And now let it ease back down. For the downwind. So turn us a little bit to the right of the hill out there. Yeah, a little bit more to the right. We're getting a little push from the crosswind, I guess. Yeah, there you go. And now lower the pitch and let's accelerate to 60. Okay, so lower the nose some more. It's almost like a helicopter. The pitch goes down quite a ways to accelerate.
You can take over if you want. I mean,
yeah. I'll tell you when to turn base and then I'll take over after that.
Are we going to go up again or is this it?
I think that's all I have time for today. Speed it up a little bit. There you go. Yeah, good times, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, let's turn base here. Keep the pitch lower. There you go. Remember to breathe. All right, I have control. Nicely done. The spoilers. Got a nice deep glide slope set up, which is what we want with this glider because its spoilers are more effective than in the 233. So our average approach angle should therefore be steeper. And the Grove has really got powerful spoilers, so it can make really steep approaches quite easily. Landing technique is just like in the 233. We'll hold this pitch attitude until we get nice and close to the ground. Then a small pitch change up to transition to level flight, like so. And then gradually holding on.